They join together as husband and wife, surrounded by the people dearest and most important to them. But I do have to tell you all that the place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriage. So if any person knows of any legal reason why Andrew and Emma may not be joined in matrimony, you should declare it now. Very quiet and well-behaved. Andrew and Emma, marriage is a commitment in life where two people can find and bring out the best in each other. It offers opportunities for sharing and growth and is a joining that has the promise of a lifetime. Marriage is a unique relationship and it takes trust to know in your hearts that you only want the best for each other. It takes dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and to grow, even if it is difficult to do so. It takes faith in each other to go forward, but most importantly, it takes love. Andrew and Emma, today you will exchange vows which will unite you as husband and wife. The words are a formal and a public pledge of your love and a promise of lifelong dedication to each other. But before you are joined in matrimony, it is my duty to remind you of the solemn and lasting character of the vows that you are about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. And I'm going to ask each of you in turn to declare that you do not know any lawful reason why you should not be married to each other today. And Andrew, what I didn't tell you was it's customary for the groom to go first.
Brilliant. Thank you.
I thought I'd say that for you. And I'm going to ask you to answer I am to the following question.
Okay.
Are you, Andrew Mark Gunn, free lawfully to marry Emma Louise Lakin?
I am.
And Emma, I'm going to ask you to answer I am to the following question. Are you, Emma Louise Lakin, free lawfully to marry Andrew Mark Gunn?
I am.
So the purpose of marriage is to enable you to make a formal commitment to each other, to care for and to support each other through everything that life brings to you. It is to accept each other's strengths and your weaknesses and to continue to grow and to learn together. And it is a promise from each of you to always treat one another with respect and with affection. And to never forget that your marriage is a continuing celebration of the love that you have today. Marriage must be entered into freely, voluntarily, and with the full and unreserved consent of you both. Therefore, Andrew, do you take Emma to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Gosh, that was emphatic.
I was just concentrating on not stumbling.
And Emma, do you take Andrew to be your lawful wedded husband?
I do.
Thank you. So, ladies and gents, friends and family, Andrew and Emma have asked me to present a reading to you at this point, and it's a reading called What is Love? What is Love? It's a journey of promise that two make together to find the happiness they'll share forever. It's a smile, a word, a gentle touch that can't be explained and yet means so much. It's making plans and seeing them through and finding new things that two can do. It's knowing the sky isn't always blue, but smiling until the sun breaks through. It's trust and confidence, no hidden fears that add to the happiness throughout the years. It's dreaming dreams just made for two and sharing the joy when they come true. It's closeness shared in a crowded street and that special thrill as true lovers meet. It's making a world where happiness holds a special magic as each day unfolds. It's when little thoughts give the heart a lift, an occasion remembered, a simple gift. It's the faith and the hope, the pride and the care, and the wonderful world which you both will share. So thank you very much for choosing that beautiful reading. Thank you. So Andrew and Emma, you have today declared yourselves free and willing to marry, so I'm going to ask that you remain facing each other and holding both hands because you are now about to make your formal vows of marriage. And again, Andrew, I'm going to ask you to go first.
Brilliant.
And say after me. I, Andrew Mark Gunn.
I, Andrew Mark Gunn.
Take you, Emma Louise Lakin.
Take you, Emma Louise Lakin.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And Emma, if you would say after me. I, Emma Louise Lakin.
I, Emma Louise Lakin.
Take you, Andrew Mark Gunn.
Take you, Andrew Mark Gunn.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
So, ladies and gentlemen, Andrew and Emma, we have now come to the exchanging of rings, which is the traditional way of sealing the marriage contract that you have just made. The wedding ring is in perfect form. It's a never-ending circle with neither a beginning nor an end. It represents your union, and we hope that you are reminded of this moment and accept it as a symbol of the promises you have just made to each other. So, Jack, it gives me very great pleasure to invite you to come forward to present the rings. And Jack, I'm going to ask that you present Emma's ring to Andrew.
Thank you.
And Andrew, if you would place Emma's ring halfway down her third finger left hand, and whilst looking at Emma, say after me. Emma, I give you this ring.
Emma, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our love.
As a symbol of our love.
And a token of our trust and commitment.
And a token of our trust and commitment.
Wear it with pride.
Wear it with pride.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
And place the ring on.
I nearly repeated that. I nearly repeated that then. Some people do. Well, I was close.
And Jack, if you present Andrew's ring to Emma. And Emma, if you will place Andrew's ring halfway down his third finger left hand, and whilst looking at Andrew, say after me. Andrew, I give you this ring.
Andrew, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our love.
As a symbol of our love.
And a token of our trust and commitment.
And a token of our trust and commitment.
Wear it with pride.
Wear it with pride.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
Place the ring on.
Wiggle.
Thank you very much, Jack. Do you want
Cheers.
To give him a clap?
Why are you clapping?
Because he's so
Thank you, Jack. Cheers. So, Andrew and Emma, you have just sealed your relationship by the giving and receiving of rings, a pledge between two people who agree that they will commit themselves to one another throughout their lives. And today you've expressed your love to one another through the loving vows that you have just made. So may you always love, honour and cherish each other. May no failure or misfortune ever part you. And may you live full, rich, but far more importantly, extremely long and happy lives together. And it is my great pleasure to be able to say that you are now husband and wife. And so, Andrew, we may kiss your bride.
Come stop your crying, it will be all right. Just take my hand, hold it tight. I will protect you from all around you. I will be here, don't you cry. For I'm so small, you seem so strong. My arms will hold you, keep you safe and warm. This bond between us can't be broken. I will be here, don't you cry. Cause you will be in my heart. Yes, you'll be in my heart. From this day. They can't explain. I know we're different, but deep inside us, we're not that different at all.
Thank you.
wonderful wedding we've all just witnessed, and such a lovely venue here at Slater's to bring family and friends together to celebrate. I think everybody knows me. If anyone doesn't, I'm Michelle, Emma's mum, and now Andrew's mother-in-law. It might have only become official today, but we've all considered Andrew part of the family now for a long time, and over the years, have lots of special memories. When I look at Emma today, I'm filled with love, pride, joy and happiness, and overwhelmed with emotion. They say when you have a daughter, you have a best friend for life. Well, I've been extremely lucky because I've had two daughters and an amazing mum, and we're all the best of friends. In life, we want the best for our children. We give them roots to grow and wings to fly. The roots give them support and structure to thrive, teaching them right from wrong, whilst embedding family values. The wings give them confidence to become independent, whilst knowing you're always there to support them when needed. When Emma was a child, she was full of energy, singing and dancing from room to room, making up dances and shows with her friends. I gave her the nickname Energetica. One of my first memories of Andrew was them both dancing to Dirty Dancing on the Just Dance game. In fact, it was the song that was played when we were leaving the ceremony. I can't remember, however, if they ever mastered the lift at the end. So I thought it might be a good idea if they wanted to give us a dance.
He's too heavy.
Only joking, we can save that for later. Emma and Andrew met at school, and after being high school prom dates, never looked back. A few years later, when they were 17-ish, we went on holiday to Lanzarote. One particular night, they were late coming back, and when trying to contact them, they weren't answering the phones. When Emma finally answered, sorry about this, I don't know if you've heard this story. When Emma finally answered, she says, "I'm sorry we are late, we can't come back yet, as Andrew's on stage."
Not true.
And he's been hypnotised.
That's absolute lies.
That's true.
It's not true.
I can't remember.
It's not true. I remember it, and it's not true.
That was true, Emma, wasn't it? Or did you just want extra time out?
Wow, more for you.
I could now say, little did they know, I'd slip the hypnotist €50 to make him my future son-in-law.
That's 50 quid you ever spent.
That would never have been necessary. From a young age, Emma always wanted to become a teacher and would line her toys up and replicate the day's lesson. This often highlighted the naughty children, because she would tell them off, as the teacher had done so on the day. Chloe, you must have been very well behaved, as you never got told off. I remember there were a few occasions when she didn't want to do her own work. She would pretend to be my teacher, and this seemed to spur her on. The lessons, however, got a little bit more difficult when she was at uni, as I struggled to keep it. It must have worked well because she graduated with a first class degree in educational psychology. Joking aside, she worked very hard throughout her education, and I'm extremely proud. At 21, she was invited to attend an interview in London at Teach First. I booked an hotel for a few days, which was near the venue, and off we went with Andrew and Paul. Little did I realise that the distance was as the crow flies and not as the feet would walk. And it's certainly not every day you get to travel via a cable car over the Thames to an interview. She was successful and has gone from strength to strength, becoming nursery manager and assistant head at only 25. Life is like a book. Every chapter is different. Some happy, some sad, some quiet, some exciting. Always remember, whatever chapter you're on, to support each other, make any future decisions together, and be faithful, loyal, and honest.
Both Emma and Andrew have solid foundations and strong family values and make a wonderful couple. They're both hardworking and have made a beautiful life and home together. It's truly been a pleasure watching you both grow up together. And as I was preparing this speech, I got to think how quick time passes and how the changes from 10 years ago to now. For both of you, we've gone from, I would give you advice, now you advise me. I'd chauffeur you around, now you do so for me. I'd cook Christmas dinner, now you cook for me. I'd phone when you're late, now you're phoning me. Don't think I'll live down missing the return airport taxi recently by 1 minute.
As real I meant, late.
One minute. Somebody else jumped in the taxi. As I mentioned earlier, I've got so many lovely memories of Emma and Andrew and could stand here all day, but I haven't better as we've got a lot of speeches to get in. However, should you want to hear any more, just feel free to find me later on. One last thing before I go. There is a little saying and advice to my son-in-law that goes, happy wife, happy life. I'm not sure whether it was a man or woman who wrote that though. And from that, can you all raise your glasses with me to wish this amazing couple a truly wonderful life together?
Emma and Andrew.
Cheers. Emma and Andrew.
For those who don't know me, I'm Chloe, one of the maids of honours. Where do I start? You were my very first friend. 23 years of friendship, it's hard to put that into brief speech. We've shared so many amazing memories and chapters over the years. It feels like only yesterday we were walking around primary school and today we're walking you down the aisle. Being the big kids we're pretending to be sisters on all them family holidays, but in fact you really are my sister from another mister. Growing up with you has given me the joy to watch you grow into the amazing person you are today. Going from playing dress up to your real life fairy tale, at least we weren't fighting over dress today. To see both my best friends go from high school love to marriage is something so special. I'm so glad that you found your soulmate in Andrew. I'm honoured to be a part of your special day and I wish you both so many years of happiness and joy to the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Gum.
No, I really am. Really scared. I do not do speeches in any way, so.
You just got married, this is nothing.
Yeah, but I'm a little weird with Google anyway. Google's told me I've got to say some thank you, so. I'll start off with a thank you for everyone here. Obviously, you're all here, wouldn't be possible without you, so. Means a lot for you all to be here. Honestly, probably off this. To be fair, it takes a lot of effort to make it out of today. If it's not for me, we wouldn't be here, would we? Because I propose. Em's also said yes, so well done. I'm not going to bore you too much, we'll do some individual thank you. So, Em's mum and dad, obviously. You've raised an okay person. I'm only joking, obviously, she's amazing, you've done a very good job, so thank you, and thank you for always welcoming me. Back to my notes.
Yeah,
my mum and dad. No, you've always supported me, looked after me, so thank you very much. I'm pretty sure everyone in this room will thank you for raising an amazing son.
And Andrew.
I've jumped the gun here. Well, thank you to all the bridesmaids. You probably kept Tam calm when I can't, but when can I? Other than the dodgy butler in Marbella, that was a bit questionable. Leave it at that, eh? But a little special. Where is she? Chloe Snape.
Special shout out, to be fair, because she's been there literally every day for the past month, make sure everything's there, so I'm very grateful. But I'm also going to be very pleased to have some food in my fridge at the end of the week. Because I've literally cooked a tea every night for about 3 weeks. My speech is short, so final thank you to Jack and the best... Jack is my best man, sorry. And the rest of the boys. There's no way I'm sharing our stories. But the stag do of recent. Thanks, boys, for pulling it off. It's brilliant. I don't know if I'll forgive you for putting me in a bail kit, though. As I say, that's it for thank yous. I'm not thanking Em, because I think she's the lucky one. Nah, I'm only joking. Everyone, I'm sure, will agree, Em looks absolutely beautiful today. I'm very happy to now call you my wife and spend the rest of my life with you. Anything else nice to say? I'm not sure. Ah, there's one more page. No, we've had a brilliant 10 years and hopefully many more. Yeah. Hopefully it won't be the end tomorrow. Well, I say, short for me, I don't do speeches. I'm concerned, but it's going to Jack now, so...
It's going to be Dad.
Oh, well... That's really the end of my speech. It was a little punchline, but Paul, I guess we'll see if it makes after this. Thank you to Michelle. Thank you to Chloe. Thank you to Andrew for them fantastic speeches. I'm going to struggle to keep up with that. On behalf of Emma and Andrew, I'd like to welcome you all to this special occasion. And just going off piste, I just want to echo Emma's comments on here. There's plenty of people here. I bet everybody in the room knows somebody who they wish were here. They'd love being here. Sadly, they're not with us physically, but they're with us heart and soul. Dad. Okay. As Emma's dad, it is, of course, for me, one of the most treasured days of my life. I'd like to say how beautiful you look, Emma. Andrew, you look beautiful as well.
That means a lot.
And how proud I am of you both. Just going to blow the news, sorry.
Just come on the table.
Emma has always been a go-getter, set out to achieve her wishes from a very early age. For example, on family holidays, for example, no sooner as we got to the hotel, it would be costume on and straight to the pool to make friends. No doubt taking after me would quickly set up what we would call the Family Olympics. With challenging games including who could make the biggest splash, who could jump the furthest into the pool, who could land on the airbed, who could jump clear over the airbed. I never used to move it, Emma, honest. If or when Emma came second or below, I would always remind her of my favourite sporting quote. Don't worry, Emma. It's not a matter of life and death. It's more important than that. And although she won't admit it, I think she secretly adheres to that philosophy now. I believe the Olympics carry on with Emma, Andrew and friends. I've even been invited to attend the next games. I'm not sure they do a veterans category though. Another trait we share, unfortunately, is end of holiday blues. Although I don't think she's suffered from pachyonitis yet, a terrible affliction, let me tell you. I think we'd both prefer the it is what it is, Andrew approach. I also need to mention the music quizzes. Our boys versus girls competition is always a highlight.
Smash me every time.
The most recent competition featuring memorable quotes like boom, hang it in the Louvre, where did he find that from, and he smashed it out of the park. Though these all been comments from the boys, having walked her all over the girls, much to Emma's annoyance. But don't worry, Emma, it's not a matter of life and death. I'd like to officially welcome Andrew to the family, even though he has always thought he has always felt part of our family, especially as he is a Stoke City supporter. I was worried we might have to wash him, but when he told me he was a Stoke City supporter. Happy days. One word of advice to you both as a married couple. I don't want any ironic laughs now. Try to live within your means. Something which Andrew still to this day urging me to do.
Sorry.
I'm sure you're both going to make a lifetime of memories together. On that note, if you'd all join me in wishing Emma and Andrew a lifetime of health, wealth and happiness together, and raise a toast to the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Gunn.
I don't really know how to start, morning. You could all walk out here not speaking to each other after this. I don't like people. Easiest way to start. But welcome everyone, you're here today for one reason and one reason only. The bar's open. The water's on after 12. Unless Seven Trent are in charge. For people who don't know me. For people who don't know me, I'm Jack, I'm Andy's mate-ish best mate. Depending on what day of the week it is. And for people that do know me, they are gobsmacked to believe that I'm in this position giving a speech. Such an important day for two people very close to all of us. So here we go. Strap yourselves in. We're in for a bleeping ride. First of all, I'd like to give an absolutely brilliant round of applause to Mrs. Gunn. Vicky, you look absolutely smashing to me. I'll be really honest, I'm so glad you and Bob have stopped gallivanting around the globe to turn up to your youngest son's wedding. The only surprise is you're not dragging a suitcase behind you, telling everyone where the next place you're going. We get it, like cruises. But seriously, Emma does look absolutely amazing today.
Yeah. She is amazing.
The only hope is, for Andy's sake, she keeps us up for the rest of the wedding. And marriage. Speaking of Seven Trent with Andy. If you've ever had the pleasure to share a car, drive with, or be a passenger in the same vehicle as Andy, you'll know he'll drive down the road and go, I worked on that bit of tarmac. That was last week, Mrs. Smith. Real bad leak. And, a couple of 1,000 litres coming out of there. Yesterday, we went down Hartwell Lane. 5 times. One road, 5 times. I get it, water runs. I get it, water's wet. I get it. You've got pride in your work, though, and that's something that you do take from your dad.
Was it a river?
Could have been. But I do always remember the first meeting with Andy. It was in college. We were in the atrium. We both got told by Chloe and Emma, listen, you're going to be meeting my boyfriend, and it's going to be, you know, it's got to be real nice. Be nice to him, be nice. He's nice, he's lovely. And I said, all right, no worries, I'll be all right, I'll be nice. And I looked at him, we locked eyes together, and we both did the same thing every man does to another man the first time they meet him. All right.
All right, mate.
Both did the old all right. He's always been a man of many words, so. But I know he was only being nice just so he could get lucky with Anna. Still waiting to find out what the answer is to me. And me.
Any chance?
This makes me worry.
It was something great, wasn't it? Agreed.
Andy is very big headed.
It's gone about like personality biology.
By genetics, you all know what I mean. But seriously, he's not a hot guy. By that, what I mean is, he's bought a hat for his honeymoon, it's double XL. And all the kids in Vietnam are now out of a job because there's no material left. But at the same time, Andy always wants to be right. You can never argue against him. He always says he's right. But just the little times where you do find out that you're right and he's wrong. My best mate Emma always barks up in the background. And she always says, Rufus? Rufus? Don't worry, Rufus. It's okay. It's okay.
Rufus.
Just let it go. Just let it go, Rufus. Come on. Come on, Rufus. And she always does have to say this before he does have a mild meltdown. And they're not that mild, I'll be really honest. Pretty feisty guy, let me tell you. But really, I'd love to say thanks to Andy for choosing me to be his best man. I really don't know if it was the drugs or the booze. But we all know there was no weapons involved. You might have just really loved me at the time. But I'm pretty sure while we were in Benidorm on your stag do, whilst you were... The only way I can describe is having a stroke at the bar table after 8 shots.
Not my fault.
Or the back-breaking sort of wrenching you were doing on the plane home.
Also not my fault.
Whatever you want to call it, really. I'm pretty sure you also weren't as thankful. But I really do hope for good times, more good times of Andy, Emmy, Chloe, the boys, and all the group over there. We have good days out at Stoke. We play golf, some of us do. And we always end up going to the pub for one, and we always end up being the last to leave. But mine and Andy's favourite pastime, we've always shared a real close connection in this. It's pretty closely known that we love winding up females to the point where they really don't want us to live with them anymore. Never mind marrying them. I really do, sorry for boring you all, this has been pretty monotone. But a fun fact of the day is, on the 1st of August 1936, Adolf Hitler opened the Olympics. So, we've always got something to think about on this day.
Thank you.
I really do have to say, I have, I'm on a list. No, it's not that list. It's the list of Vicky, Chloe, and all other close members of the party that really hate the fact that I'm speaking in public and anything could slip out of my mouth. This speech has had to be vetted. I have got multiple pages of okay, not okay. So, this is it for me. I'm going to put the mic down. There's not a mic here, but I'll put it down. I really am grateful. The real speech where I do keep all the juicy bits in will be at the bar. It's a Guinness or two if you're feeling generous. Congratulations to Andy and Emma, I love you both so much. So.
West Virginia, blue ridge mountains, shining old river. Life is older, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia. Mama, take me home, country roads. All my memories gather round her. Miner's lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky. Misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eye. Country roads, oh, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, oh, mountain mama, take me home. Country roads, oh, take me home. I hear a voice in the morning hour, she calls me. The radio reminds me of my home, far away. Driving down the road, I get a feeling I should have been home yesterday. Yesterday.